This is Mike, who says, on my way home from work, I often see a man holding a cardboard sign saying he will work for food. Some people give him money, but I feel uncomfortable. How do you think Jesus would handle this situation?
Jesus said, give to those that ask of you. You know, if somebody's hurting, don't turn them away. How would he handle it? He'd give him some money. Mm-hmm. I tell you, though, when I lived in New York, there were people who were always, they wanted to get food, money to buy booze. So a guy hit me up on the street, you know, said, I want to go to Staten Island or wherever it was. I've got to get across to Jersey. I've got to have fare for the ferry. And, but I need something to eat. I'm hungry. I thought, okay, I'm going to take you across the street to the automat right across the street, and I'm going to buy you food. He looks so disappointed.
I know. I think you're absolutely right about that, because I've had that happen to me on a number of occasions where people will say that they've run out of gas, and could I give them enough money to get back home? They live across the state line.
Yeah.
And after you're asked that two or three times, you think, you know, there's something going on here. So, I think giving them, if they need food, you give them food.
Yeah,
and
if they need gas, find their car, take it to a filling station, put a couple of dollars worth of gas
in the car.
All right, what else?
This is Eric, who says, I know the Bible talks about generational curses and that we need to break those. Are there such things as generational curses, and how can I pass those on to my family?
Well, God says that I will bless those to the third and fourth generation, actually to thousands of generations of those who love me. And the sins of the fathers will be visited to the third and fourth generation. You can look at a lot of things genetically. You can look at cultural. You can look at predisposition to sin and to alcoholism and so forth. And you add it all up and down, and the answer is they do go through generations. How do you break it? You've got to specifically break the curse in Jesus' name, speak it clearly, and then act accordingly.
I want to say that we have more information about generational curses on our website. You really do need to find out about this. Go to CBN.com, click on the Bring It On Extra link. Okay, Pat, this is Kirk, who says, I'm concerned about how Islam is taking over much of our world. In addition to praying, do you have some suggestions of how we can stop its progression in our country?
Yeah, you can help CBN. We have more Arabic language Christian programming than any other organization in the world. And we have all kinds of programs. We have full language Farsi. We have Urdu. We have all kinds of things. And big ministry to the Kabyle Berbers in North Africa. What do? Well, you
share the gospel.
Take them something better. That's what you do. You take them the love of God and say, Jesus loves you, and here it is. But you don't. It's better to light a candle than to curse the darkness. What else?
Josiah says, is there a difference between an atheist and an agnostic? My roommate says neither one believes in God, so what do they believe?
Not true. Gnosis, G-N-O-S-I-S, is the word for knowledge, and agnostic means I don't know. Theist is God, and A means no God. And an atheist says there is no God. An agnostic says, I just don't know about him.
Yeah, if you can show me, if you can give me facts.
Yeah, but I mean, it may have the same practical end, but that's the way they work. Hey, that's all the time we've got. Thanks for those questions. And we leave you today with these words from Romans 12:21. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. That's just exactly what I was talking about. Amen. I'm glad Paul got there first. All right.